गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। ओके, लेट्स वेट फॉर 1 मोर मिनट, देन आई स्टार्ट द क्लास। ओके। Is my screen is visible? Are you able to see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, so today's topic is rate analysis. So we'll start with what is the purpose, what is rate analysis? So basically the rate analysis is the basis of arriving at correct or reasonable rate per unit work for a particular item following its specification and detailed survey of material, labor, equipment, etc. That is to reach rate of concrete. Suppose is an example given, rate of concrete per cubic meter. Individual cost of fall lines are considered. So basically in rate analysis what we do, we club together different, suppose a unit of work. Suppose you are saying that you are doing a plastering. Plastering for a particular unit, that is one. Suppose in plastic you measure the quantities in meter square. So what will be the cost in 1 meter square? Then you will calculate, suppose you got the rate for 1 meter square, then you can just multiply with the rate with the total meter square in the whole plaster in the whole project. Understood? Likewise, if you can calculate what will be the cost for 1 cubic meter of concrete, then you can, if you get the in the whole project, you suppose, okay, let me note. Suppose in concreting, if you get the rate of 1 meter cube of concrete, suppose it is 1 meter, to make the 1 meter cube of concrete, it is costing you ₹50. Okay, and in the whole project, or suppose you are constructing a building, in the whole building you need 5,000 meter cube of concrete. So what you can do? You can multiply this 50 with 5,000. You will get the actual cost of actual cost of the whole concrete, right? So you what you we do in rate analysis was, first we calculate what will be the rate, what will be this rate for doing unit work, any work. The for that 1 meter cube, 1 meter square. So we found out the what will be the rate for doing 1 unit of work, whether it is term of concrete, plastering, anything. For materials, cement, sand, aggregate, steel, labor. Okay, in terms of labor, we used to calculate that for 1 meter cube of plastering, what will be the labor cost? Okay, what will be the labor cost per cubic meter of concrete? what will be the equipment charges for 1 cubic meter of con they have given an ex
अभी
yes they have given an example for rate of concrete per cubic meter. So for concrete it will require material, right? Cement, sand, aggregate, steel, admixture used for per cubic meter. So they will find out what will be the cost of material for 1 cubic meter. Then what will be the cost of labor for 1 cubic meter concrete? Then they will find out what will be the cost of equipment for equipment like vibrator, pump, transit mixer, batching plant per cubic concrete. So see, in just preparing a concrete, you need all these cost. At the end, all costs were clubbed together to give you the final rate of preparing 1 cubic meter of concrete. Understood or not? What is rate analysis? Suppose in plastering, what will be the? It will have material like cement, sand, water, and it will have labor cost. And in equipments, it may have those shovels. But that won't be cost because in plastering, generally the cost will be for material and labors. So basically, the purpose of rate analysis is to determine the current rate per unit of an item at the locality. So when you fix a mason or a labor, they used to tell you the rate for 1 cubic meter. That we used to take for our rate is 1 cubic meter. For 1 cubic meter, we have this much of rate. Like that, they used to deal with the owner to examine the viability of rates offered by contractors. So to examine, okay, sometimes if you don't have the rate analysis of a particular work, contractor may charge you more. Okay. He may say that for 1 cubic meter my rate is 100, but when you calculate that for 1 cubic meter of concrete it is costing you 60 rupees, so he's telling you 40 rupees more, right? So that is one of the reason to calculate labor strength and equipment required for project planning and to fix up labor contract rates. So these are the different purposes: to fix the current rate, to determine the current rate, how much is the offered rate by the contractors, quantities and contract rates. Now, how can you fix up rate per unit item per unit of an item? So it has based on quantity of materials and cost, labor cost, equipment, tools and plant cost, overhead and establishment charges or profit. So you can come to come so the unit rate, suppose a concrete, for concrete it will have material cost, labor cost, equipment cost, some overhead or contingency or establishment charge may be there, and plus profit. So after clubbing this, the rate you are getting, you'll get for unit rate for preparing 1 meter cube of concrete, or you can take an example 1 meter square of plastering, like that. So you can come to you can fix the rate by clubbing these rates: quantities of material, labor cost, equipment cost, overhead plus profit. Okay. How to fix up rate per unit of an item? So in under quantity of material and cost, as per detailed specification, quantity of an item is calculated. So from the detailed specification, we will calculate how much will be the quantity how much will be the quantity of any work based on market rates per unit rate is arrived. So we'll compare the rates with the market rates. We'll come to per unit rate. Following cost two is considered: freight and transportation, including loading and unloading, taxes and insurance, profit on cement, steel, so stone chips and bitumen, not included if supplied departmentally. So in the material cost, you can there will be some transportation charge, It may include loading and unloading when a truck full of cement used to come on site. Labor used to cost for the unloading charges also. So that will also comes under your material cost. And there may be some taxes and insurance. So when you purchase on bulk, usually if the big farms used to purchase in big amount like 1,000 bags, they have to pay some taxes also to the government. So, and profit on cement, steel, stone chips and bitumen not included if supplied departmentally. So for quantity of materials, these will how can you arrive at the unit of an item? A detailed specification will be given. They will mention the how much quantity is required. You just multiply with the suppose they have mentioned that 100 bags of cement will be required. So for one bag, you know, 720 rupees. So just multiply with the 100 or 1,000 number of bags given as per detailed specification, and the 720 is the market rate. Then you can calculate what will be the rate for one unit. Okay, and in that you can also add transportation charges, unloading, loading, labor charges, any tax or insurance. Okay, now for labor cost. Number and wages of different categories of labors, namely mason or carpenter, mazdoor, for per unit of an item to execute at site. So different in building construction, you will need different types of labors, right? Different types of labors, mason, some will be skilled, some will be unskilled. So based on that, different charges all have different wages. So you have to calculate for what work. For which work, which mason is required, and what is the wages, and how many numbers. These numbers are multiplied by market rate, and labor cost is arrived per unit of item. Now for equipment, tools and plant. Equipment for general use as per item. Example, you can take concrete mixture as per unit of concrete. Certain tools and plants are difficult to allocate as per the specific item, hence their cost are considered in establishment charges. And for special equipment, we used to keep 1 to 1.5% of estimated cost. Now for overhead and establishment charges like office rent, depreciation on equipments, salaries of office staff, postage, lightning, traveling, telephone account. This is usually 2.5 up to 5%. Overhead charges increases with delay in project. So for overhead and establishment charge, we used to keep 2.5 to 5%. And now there are two types of overheads, general and job overhead. If we see under general overheads, these are the general overheads, and some job overheads will be salaries of technical and non-technical staff, temporary sheds, small tools, ladders, repairs, lightning, mobilization, public relations, labor welfare and safety, workmen, compensation, interest on investment and theft or loss. So these overheads you have to consider, and you have to keep you have to keep extra percentage, or you have to add extra percentage for in under the name of overhead and establishment charge, which is 2.5 to up to 5%. Next, profit. General 10% profit is considered for ordinary contracts after allocating all charges of equipment establishment. For small jobs, profit is 15%. For large project, profit is 8%. So generally, 10% profit is considered in all project works. And if the project is... I'm sorry. Okay. For small jobs, profit is used to keep 15%. And for large project, profit is to keep as 8%. So for profit, 10%. Generally 10, but if it's small, then 15. If it's large, it's 8%. For overhead, we used to keep 2.5 to up to 5%. स्पेशल इक्विपमेंट 1 to 1.5% एंड लेबर कॉस्ट बेस्ड ऑन द वेजेस ऑफ डिफरेंट लेबर्स एंड नंबर्स एंड फॉर क्वांटिटीज ऑफ मटेरियल विल गेट द क्वांटिटी फ्रॉम द डिटेल स्पेसिफिकेशन एंड वी कैन मल्टीप्लाई विद द मार्केट रेट टू अराइव एट यूनिट रेट. Now next is the factors affecting the rate analysis. What are the factors which affect the rate analysis? We'll do some rate analysis also, don't worry. Now next is specification of an item. So your rate will depend on your specification. So under the specification of item, it will be like what is the quality, how much is the proportion, or you can say quantity, method of construction, and protection of work. So these will affect your the rate analysis, the rate of a particular work, rate of materials for item of work up to work site, daily wages of laborer with different categories, with localities or as per outputs, the range of lead and lift the range of lead and lift required for deposition of materials. Lead and lift is your excavation. Some part you excavate and some part you dump at some portions, right? So that range also in your road construction. Percentage charge for overheads. Possibility of theft of losses. Range of profit. Availability of water connections. So these are the some factors which affect the rate analysis. Now let's take an example. Quantities of coarse aggregate, say sand and cement for various proportion of concrete. So let's see, quantities shall be calculated for 10 cubic meter of concrete. Sorry, it will be 1 cubic meter of concrete. To calculate dry ingredients for 1 cubic meter of concrete, each proportional quantity for 1 cubic meter of concrete is multiplied with 15.4 up to 15.7. So suppose you have to find out what will be the dry quantity for of cement, sand and stone in preparing 1 cubic meter of concrete in this ratio, 1 is to 2 is to 4. So how can you find out the cement? How much will be the cement? This one, if you see, this one divided by the proportion, sum of proportion, 1 plus 2 plus 4 multiplied by 15.4, which is 2.2 cubic meter. If you convert in kg, it will be 3168 kg, and if you convert in bag, it will be 64 bag. In one bag cement, we used to get 50 kg cement. So in that you can convert it in numbers. Now for sand, it is as a fine aggregate also, so it is 2. So 2 divided by 1 plus 2 plus 4 again multiplied by 15.4. So this is my 4.4 cubic meter for, so it's for sand is required 4.4 cubic meter to prepare a 1 cubic meter of concrete in this ratio. So it is this much cubic meter, and if I convert in tons, so it will be 7.25 tons. Same with stone chips, or you can say for coarse aggregate, they have calculated it will be like 4 divided by 1 is to 2 is to 4 multiplied by 15.4, you will get 8.8 cubic meter and 18 tons. So for different proportions, different cement in cubic meter and bags, dry sand and stone chips are given. A graph is also given, like cement, sand, dry sand and fine aggregate and coarse aggregate for 1 is to 1 is to 2 ratio. So different ratio different is given. It is 10 cubic meter only. They have found out for 10 cubic meter. Now material quantity of materials required for different item of work. So for brickwork. For brickwork, they have found out for 10 cubic meter, like somewhere 100 square meter. So you can find one for 1 cubic meter also. So for brickwork,
For 10 cubic meter, you need material is 19 by 9 into 9, that is size of the brick. You will require 5000. You will require 5000 numbers of bricks for 10 cubic meter. And for that, for dry cement, you will require 3.5 cubic meter. And if you are constructing half brick, it will require again 5000. Random rubble masonry you will require. So these are the different quantities given for different item of work, and they have calculated it. So for different work, different quantities is given. So these are material estimation. Once material estimation is done, we'll go to labor estimation. That means what estimation is, we come to a conclusion that this much amount of work will be required and this much will be the rate if you multiply these rates with market rates or the schedule of rates prepared by the government. Now, under labor estimation, wages vary as per different classes of labor. Length of time required to finish depends on type of work, amount of work, type of skill required, mental development of work, surrounding area, weather, labor availability, local customs, and local laws. So, task or outturn work. Outturn work means the work which cannot be finished by using only designated skill or unskilled labor alone. Both or more types of labor shall be involved to finish the task. So, in work, one is task and one is outturn work. In outturn work, the work cannot be finished by only designated skill or unskilled labor. Both types of labor will be required to finish the work. So an example is given. A mason can complete 1.5 cubic meter brick work in 8 hours, provided he is helped by two mazdoors to carry and mixing ingredients of mortar, and also to carry and place materials. So some brickwork is going on. So a mason who is to do the brickwork, he can complete the 1.5 cubic meter of brickwork in 8 hours if he is helped by two mazdoor to carry. So when you see a construction of a wall by a mason, you will see two labors or sometimes more labors are also involved. To some will make the mortar, some will help in giving the bricks to the mason likewise. So this is in outturn work, both unskilled and skilled labor is required to complete a task. And in task, only some specific skilled person is required to carry out the work. For labor output, cement concrete in foundation for 10 cubic meter, you will need 1 by 4 head masons, 2 masons, and 20 mazdoors. So for foundation, you will need 20 mazdoors. They have calculated. In this, they have shown how much is the number of labors required for a particular work. So for different work, these are the labors required. Now, an example is given, analysis of rates for earthwork. So, earthwork in excavation in trenches for foundation and for pipes, cables, not exceeding 1.5 meter width, lift is 1.5 meter, lead is 30 meter, and the soil type is ordinary soil for 10 cubic meter. So, in this, mazdoor 3.25, and for one mazdoor rate is 450 multiplied. This is the amount. Water, we need one person, which is the rate is 14.6 amount it is costing. So like this is the format. You come to a conclusion that per cubic meter this much will be the charge. Again, these detail specification will be given to you on your these detail specification will be given on your this detail specification. These are the specification. How much should be the how much the width of the excavation? How what will be the type of soil? So for different artwork, these are the ways of writing the analysis of rate. Now, in concrete work, no steel inside. It is mentioned for concrete work, no steel inside. You will need head mason, mazdoor. You will require stone blast, sand, cement. There will be some contingency, water, profit, and overhead. So, like these are the quantities, these are the fixed rates as per market rate or the schedule rates, and they just these quantities are multiplied. The thing is to calculate the quantity of these different works and to get the this rate. Now, this rate is per cubic meter of concrete work. Okay, this rate you have come to a conclusion of that for 1 cubic meter, this will be the rate after adding different labor charges, different material charges, plus some profit and overhead charges. So you come to a conclusion that this much will be the rate of this much will be the rate of unit rate of doing 1 cubic meter of concrete. Okay, so suppose after that you got that you need 5,000 cubic meter of concrete in the project, then you just multiply with 4029, you will get the whole cost for only concrete. Now here it was ratio was given 1:4:8, and the stone blast was 40 mm down. So now the ratio has changed, so the quantity will also change, rate will also rate are similar. If you see 800 for head mason, 600, 450 for mazdoor, stone blast is 1200. So rates are the same, rates will be same, the quantity will differ. Here it was 40 mm, that's why 4.9.6. Here is 20 mm, so 8.8 they have calculated. So the finding of this quantity and arriving at a rate, which is total rate, which will be the rate of unit rate, is known as basically we are analyzing the rate. Now for in if you construct a building, there will be some fittings, right? Supplying fittings, shuttering and staging. So that rate also be considered when you cast a slab or column. Some mason used to form the formwork, so that will also be cost. Timber shuttering can be used max 12 times, so you can use the same shuttering 12 times. Steel formwork can be used 40 times. So formwork for steels can be used for 40 times. At the end of the life, scrap value is 8 to 12%. Calculate cost of shuttering materials as new purchase. Deduct scrap value and divide balance into 12 months period or 40 months period. So you can also suppose the same you have used the shuttering in one project. And another project also you are using the same shuttering. So that cost won't be added on the other project. That you can deduct if you are considered, then you can deduct. These are this is the so these is the analysis rate for 1 square meter of shuttering. For shuttering, the quantity was 1.139. The rate was 55,000. So amount is this much. For different types of shuttering. Now scrap value. Some will be deteriorate, and you can use for 12 time, once time. So likewise for different works, how much, how it, what will be the mazdoors required for making those shutterings, then nails and some contingencies they have added. So this will be the cost of shuttering for 1 square meter. That is 695.8619. Now this shuttering was for beam and slab. This is for footing work. So for different work, different shuttering will have different rate. Likewise, to find out these rates is all about your rate analysis. Now RCC work is given. Rate is 1:1.5:3. for beam with 2% of steel. Now consider 10 cubic meter of concrete. Steel required is 0.2 cubic meter, which is 1570 kg. And to bind the reinforcement, you can consider 15.7 kg. We'll consider, used to consider 1% of that kg. That means for this much of concrete and 2% of steel, we need 1570 kg of steel. And for binding wire, we used to consider 1% of this much of kg, that is 15.7 kg. So for RCC work, these are the material analysis, like stone, sand, cement, steel, binding wire, shuttering material on hire. Now next will be the labor cost. Third is the contingency. T is the water charges. And you overhead, profit and overhead. So this is the charge. Now this is the total cost for 10 cubic meter. 32914.9. Now to get the 1, just divided it, you will get the rate for 1 cubic meter, which is 32912.4. Understood? The main thing is now you have to first able to find out the quantities of different work. For different work, you should know how to find out the quantities. Once you have got the quantities, you just can multiply with the market rate and market rate or schedule of rates of the government to get the amount. Club it, you will get the rate for 1 cubic meter of RCC. If you have any doubts, you ask me right there, okay? Now here it was ratio was 1:1.5:3. Now the next is 1:2:4, which is used for lintel with 0.9 of steel. Consider 10 cubic meter of concrete. So steel required, they have found out 707 kg. Now for binding those steel, always take 1% of that much of main steel, which is 7 kg. Likewise, they have added all the charges, labor, material, labor, contingency, water. They come to a rate that for 1 cubic meter of RCC work for lintel will cost 18798. Likewise, for different work, for brick work, they have calculated. So, in the next class, we'll study about how to find out these rates. Quantities. Okay, rates will be given from market and SOR, schedule of rates. Now you have to find what will be the quantity. Likewise, for different work, different ways to find out these quantities. So we'll see how to find out these quantities for DPC. So for every work, they have found out the what will be the cost for 1 cubic meter. Now this for plastering. Now these are the rate of analysis for roadworks. So I'll text in the group, then you join for the next class, okay? And attendance has been marked in from the participant list, so now need to write the roll numbers. Okay, then see you in the next class. I'll text, then please join. Any doubts? Okay, ask in the next class.